Now ISE it comes in question number 1, also in ICSE. ICSE it is 20 mark, ISE it is 25. ICSE gives you the option of 300 to 350 words, where ISE 400 to 450 words. Obviously the standard differs with the increase in the number of words. With narrative composition, you have to keep the term in mind: narrative, narration, narrator or narrate. Now, if narrator himself or herself is a character in the story, it is called intrusive narration. We have studied Great Expectations by Charles Dickens, or you may have studied some other stories which include the writer as a character in it. So those are all intrusive narration. Now the opposite of it is called unintrusive narration. You have to present yourself as a character of your original age. Don't try to present yourself as a man of 40, 50, 60. In that case, there will be some discontinuity and problem in your writing. So, to maintain the neutral attitude of the writing, mention your original age in that essay. Now, what are the basic things that you need to need? You need to know, don't forget, no spelling mistakes. That is a kind of crime. No shorthands, just like IE, EG, ETC, EX. Avoid writing numbers. Instead, write that one in words. At least 3 paragraphs, because few paragraphs make one essay. Words into sentence, sentence into paragraph, and paragraphs will convert 3 or 4 paragraphs will make one essay. First of all, let us take a closer look at narrative essay definition. A narrative essay is a short story about your experience, either imaginary or real. It can also tell a story of somebody's life. But keep it in mind, it is a narration of your own. So, you are the narrator. The planning phrase. Think about the essay topic and how your life experience correlates with it. Even a small fact, idea or goal can become good narrative story ideas. Think about your emotion. The more passionate you will be, the more effective your assignment. Another good idea when you are wondering how to start writing a narrative essay is to recall detail of your story. People and object, setting and session, season, event sequence. Think about the sequence of events and remember, no detail is too small. But you should be careful of the time. You can use brainstorming method also for better outcome. Start with an introductory phrase, if possible. It has to be short and catchy. An unexpected point of view is always interesting to get acquainted with. State the thesis. Write supporting sentences. Give reason why the story you are sharing is significant. So you have to infuse the importance in your story. Otherwise, the story will be of no value. It should catch the attention of the reader. And catchy statement to begin with, you can use proverb or idioms also, if possible. Otherwise, you can start it simply. Check the main body particularities. Your entire story is concentrated in body paragraphs from 3 to as many as you wish. Check the general guidelines on how to write a good narrative body. Provide one idea per paragraph. Your story has to follow some logical pattern, and chronological is the easiest one. So chronology should be mentioned. Time, place and action should have the proper connection. Time should be mentioned with a presence of mind. With every new paragraph, emphasize the significance of experience and the universal truth the story brings to the audience. So here, if you do that one, your story will have the touch of reality and it should not become an utopia. In that case, your story will be catchy and obviously will get more importance. Your personal writing style is important. It can be philosophical, careful, that requires certain knowledge, ironical, critical, or romantic. Whatever you choose, it has to be you from the top to bottom. The writing style is like an autograph. Work on it carefully so that the story should be interesting. Develop an outstanding conclusion. You are almost there. You just need to write a good concluding sentence for your essay. The conclusion is as important as an introduction. It leaves the after state. You may ask, how to write a conclusion for an essay? And here is the idea. Summarize. If you don't like summarizing, or it does not fit the style of the story, wrap it up with a rhetorical question or plans for future, so you can keep open-ending. Give your readers an idea. Think about the central message of the story and remind of it, so you can give one moral of the story. Leave your readers with a feeling that they need to sit back and think about the problems you brought up. Leave the experiencing a pleasant aftertaste. That means you can give some question to the readers, that the readers should think that what was the error, what was the correct thing, and what are the other things related to the story. They should think. But while doing all these things, don't run out of your time. Be careful of the time, because time is limited here. Now remember, keep it clear, avoid complex words and syntax. Avoid describing every your movement. At the same time, even a single lost detail can skew readers' understanding of the story. So be careful, neither write too much nor write too less. There should not be any exaggeration. Don't use the second person narrative. Good narrative stories usually written in first person. When you use I, you are engaging your readers with an immediacy of the story. Use dynamic word and active voice. Think about your writing as it was the speech. What words, idioms, slangs, and turns of phrases would you use? Try not to sound too clinical. No passive construction. So be careful, don't use such words which are obscene. Neither try to exaggerate any of the point. And obviously, it should be I. You should include yourself as many times as possible, so the narration will go valid and very, very interesting. While on a picnic, you and your friends decide to go sailing. Unfortunately, your boat capsizes in a violent storm. However, all of you manage to swim to safety. Give a vivid account of the incident. Here is the introduction. In the summer vacation, the days are long and there is a lot to do. One can laze, read and enjoy a lot. One day, my friends and I took off for a picnic. So here I have provided one specimen essay. Now, if you want to read the same one, what you should do? There is one speed option, tempo option. You can decrease the speed of the playback speed of this very video in YouTube so that the video runs slow. Playback speed should be decreased so the video will run slow and you will be able to write all these things displayed here. So, children, this is the specimen one. If you wish, you can go through this one. But more than that, the points mentioned here from the beginning till the end, you should be very careful. You should write down those things in your copy. And in finding any kind of doubts, you should let me know. Narrative essays are very easy to write. And obviously, we have to talk about marks. It gives us marks. So be careful. Try to write your own one or two essays. And send me those essays so that I can check those. One question is this. Siblings often grow up side by side in families yet have very different life experiences. If you have one or more siblings and feel that your lives have differed significantly, write an essay explaining the reason and the effects of such differences. This is homework. Send me. In case of any difficulty, you must inform me. Thank you very much.